Welcome back to Modern Salon TV. I'm TJ Hughes.
And I'm Trevor Dineen. Last episode, we went to Matrix artistic designer Nicholas French's home in the Hamptons.
Got a tip from celeb stylist Nick Arojo.
And learned how to remove length from a client's hair without cutting it. To watch these segments and more, check out Modern's video library.
This episode, we get an exclusive behind the scenes at the photo shoot of Naha's Hairstylist of the Year.
Show you exactly what happened at the 2011 Naha ceremony, as well as a quick peek at highlights from the Professional Beauty Association's Beauty Week in Vegas.
We also check out the Teen Choice Awards.
And get a fantastic makeup application tip for making eye shapes pop.
The North American Hairstyling Awards 2011 show is in the bag. In case you missed the Vegas Awards ceremony during the Professional Beauty Association's Beauty Week, here's a recap to bring you up to speed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lifetime Award recipient, Michael O'Rourke.
I'm just forever grateful, so thank you so much.
I really appreciate this award. I appreciate this opportunity. I've dedicated my life to this industry happily, and thank you again, Naha.
From celebrating new talent at Beacon, the City of Hope Gala, to new product launches on the show floor, PBA's Beauty Week is an event to remember. Miss all the industry excitement? Here's a short recap.
The Professional Beauty Association's Beauty Week, held in Las Vegas, just wrapped. And it was a whirlwind full of events like City of Hope, Casa Prof North America, Beacon, Symposium, and of course the North American Hairstyling Awards. New trends were established, products were launched, and business building was top of mind. Be sure to tune into the next episode of Modern Salon TV for the full report.
This episode is brought to you by Matrix Total Results. Click on our banner to discover the total results difference.
Next, we go behind the scenes for the winning photo shoot for Lock and Loaded's Eli Mancha, who just nabbed the Naha's Hairstylist of the Year award. In this Modern TV exclusive, we show you how Mancha created the looks and what made him go home with the biggest industry award.
The Teen Choice Awards isn't just the event that proves which stars are hot with today's youth. It's also a spot where trends are set and celebs strut their stuff. What happened at this year's Teen Choice? Let's find out.
This is Teen Choice 2011, the biggest teen party in the world.
Everybody, it's about that.
The Teen Choice Awards celebrated the newest generation of Hollywood entertainers as chosen by fans. The young nominees and attendees brought fresh energy to the red carpet, with fun hair and makeup styles that showed off glowing skin, dramatic eyes, or bold lips. Ashley Green showed off sleek and shiny strands with sun-kissed skin.
Thank you for everyone who voted for us.
Selena Gomez played up her soft side with loose waves and glossy pink lips, while her BFF Demi Lovato also went with soft waves and rosy lips.
Hi, thank you so much.
Blake Lively's melon-colored dress set off her flowing blonde locks and bronzed skin, while Emma Stone went with dramatic eyes and side-swept bangs that was a little more cool and casual. Last but not least was Taylor Swift, who ditched her usual curly look for straight locks pulled back into a chic pony. Got a favorite look seen at the Teen Choice Awards? Make sure to tell us which ones you loved on Modern's Facebook wall at facebook.com/modernsalon.
What's up, Teen Choice Awards?
Certain eye shapes demand different techniques of applying makeup to really show off its elegance. So, makeup artist Julie Pope gives us a quick tip on how to accentuate our model's natural beauty.
Hi, my name is Julie Pope. I'm going to show you a great tip for working on Asian eyes. In the salon, a lot of times we tend to focus traditionally on the top lid, but really bringing the attention to the low line so that way we can make it special and intensify the look. I'm going to start out by using the TG Perfect liner on the bottom of the lid and just gently taking it from the outside and blending it towards the center, flipping around and just smudging it a bit so we could have it that nice smoky line. To intensify the look, I'm going to go ahead and take a lighter pigmented shadow starting at the center and blending up and out and down just to meet the line. There we go, and we have a great tip for Asian eyes.
What brought you to the beauty industry and what keeps you inspired every day? We posed that question to Chris Barron, Redken's Education Artistic Director. Here's why he fell in love with beauty.
Hi, my name is Chris Barron. I'm the Education Artistic Director for Education for Redken. And the reason why I became a hairdresser is just an interesting story. At first, it was just a job for me. I partied late. I did all of those things that no employer would want to hire me for. And my wake-up call came when a client sat in my chair and said, "Chris, don't cut my hair today because I'm going to Montreal to get a good haircut." That's where the light bulb went on. That's where I knew that from that point on, it was about becoming a hairdresser and not just having a job. That's where I got hooked on education. That's where I find out that this is the best industry that you could possibly be in.
Thanks for tuning in.
Next episode, we attend John Paul Mitchell Systems, The Gathering in Vegas, and bring you the full recap of Beauty Week.
But first, here are some of your favorite industry faces.
Hi, we're watching Modern Salon TV.
Hi, I'm Ryan Nicholas from the A-List New York on Logo, and you're watching Modern Salon TV.